motivated.
Get motivated.
Get motivated. Hip hop motivated. Blowing wisdom on the mic with Sean.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to a live broadcast of Flow of Wisdom. I'm your host, Sean Anthony. Flowofwisdom.com is my website. Get you connected to me. Let's get right into it. Designer babies. You know, I did a show about this subject some time ago, and you know, some news recently has come out that has been really sparking a lot of conversation as well as controversy all throughout the globe. The first CRISPR babies were born just recently, last month, and the scientist behind it, his name is He Jiankui, and I'm telling you that this is really, really mind-boggling news and information that has come out publicly. And, you know, I find it interesting that, you know, Flow of Wisdom consistently covers these niche subjects. And when things kind of hit the mainstream, if you will, it's like, okay, again, it just reminds me that we are on the right track as it pertains to the research and information that we've been consistently diving in over the recent years. Out of China, this is a lot of controversial debate and talks on this subject. You know, even when I talked about it, I think it was last year I did the show called Designer Babies, and talking about subjects just, you know, being able to edit genes. Okay, you know, on the Flow of Wisdom Instagram, I put a short video up just talking about the recent news that came out last week. Surprisingly, a lot of people made comments about it and were aware of this news story. But we're not talking about genetically modified foods or vegetables or anything like that. We're talking about genetically modified babies. Now, it's very, very controversial because you're messing with DNA. You're messing with the way that natural creation happens, okay? And it's going to come to a point, like a lot of people, let me just slow down. What this doctor did, He Jiankui, he edited a particular gene out of the DNA and injected into a woman, and the woman gave birth to twins. Okay, and let me pull this article up. ScientificAmerican.com. Criticism rained down since the revelation earlier this week that his name looks like he, it's spelled H-E, but it's pronounced her, had used the CRISPR Cas9 to modify the CCR5 gene in two embryos, which he then implanted in a woman. The gene encodes a protein that many strains of HIV use to infect immune cells in two embryos, which he then implanted in a woman. So, like, I don't even have the article that I was reading last week in front of me, but I'm going off the top of my head. The purpose, one of the things that the whole purpose of this doctor editing out these genes, it was to prevent, you know, the spread of HIV, cholera, and what was the other one? Smallpox. So it was the whole point and purpose is to, you know, prevent, you know, this particular trait. So a lot of other scientists have been giving him flack because it's so controversial and people, so many people, other scientists were opposed to it, that it's causing up a stir in the scientific community. I want to put a couple of rhetorical questions out there for you guys. What are your thoughts on this? Is this scary to you? Do you subscribe to the whole notion of designer babies, of being able to edit your future children in a way that you want? If you want your child to have a certain eye color, a certain grade of hair, or a certain skin complexion, a certain height, all of these different things come into play when you talk about gene editing. So lots of questions and a whole lot of speculation, but a very interesting dialogue that we can begin here on the show today. 877-300-7645 is the number to call. There's in this article in front of me that I just was mentioning, Scientific American, they posed some questions, six questions that remain. And one of them is Jiankui in trouble? We'll get into that. Are his claims accurate? We'll get into that. How exactly did CRISPR edit the twin genomes? We'll get into that. When will there be another gene-edited human? That's a big question. Because once you open up this can, one could only imagine what could possibly happen in the future. Will Hu's revelations hamper ethical efforts to do germline editing? Germline editing. And the final sixth question that this article poses is, how will scientists ensure better oversight of germline editing in the future? So just lots of questions we can talk about. And in addition to this subject, I'll add on to some previous conversations that we've had on the show that sort of related to this. There was a story that I talked about, this may have been last summer, about the fertility doctor trying to commercialize three parent babies. It was a startup called Darwin Life. In fact, I wrote a little article on flowofwisdom.com about this, and the whole fertility doctor created this company called Darwin Life, says it will use controversial fertility technique to help 40 somethings get pregnant for $100,000. Now, what's interesting with this story and the CRISPR story, the gene editing story, and some others, is that it's being done outside of the United States because of certain regulations in science that you can't do these type of experiments in the United States and some other countries. However, China has allowed her to be able to proceed and do this. Even he's gotten funding for this, they're still flat from it because of how controversial it is. And he's kind of kept things under wraps with the people, the couple that he has, not the couple, but the woman that he implanted these edited gene eggs into the embryo. This is very, very controversial. Are you for this? Are you against it? Do you think this is something that that they should continue to work on? Do you think that this could be the future of having a healthy, non-disease society? Like, there's a lot of pros and cons in the conversation about this controversial topic that it's really, really wide open for lots of discussion. So lots of stuff that we're going to touch on today, and we'll try to stay on course. In addition to some of those subjects, there were some things that I also we'll just touch on briefly. I won't really go into too many details. I don't know if you guys just heard on the news right before my broadcast that the military has awarded a large amount of money for these HoloLens for military personnel to use augmented reality in the battlefield to help, I guess, be more accurate and make quicker and better decisions during the heat of battle. All of this technology stuff is seriously advancing at a phenomenal rate that society is really unable to keep up with. And, like I mentioned on last week's show, there's there's a great deal of people that are unaware. And as I mentioned last week, this stuff that's going on right now is for the future. Even though they're developing it and working on it right now today, this impact will be on our children's children. The impact of all the technology that they are working on right now and pouring in hundreds of to billions of dollars into the technology, it's going to impact our future. It may not be in our time, our lifetime, but rest assured, it definitely will be in our children's and our children's children's lifetime. They will be the ones that will have the greatest impact. So what are we going to do as far as our responsibility of being privy to this information? How are we going to pass this down and better equip the future, the people? Because at the end of the day, that's what matters. That's how a society will drive forward on how we respond to this technology. So we will be very phone interactive today. I want to welcome all of those that are listening, that streaming online at GCNLive.com and all the great affiliates across the United States and in Guam. Flow of Wisdom is broadcasting live right now in Guam, and I definitely welcome all those that are listening. Please feel free to call in. The toll-free number is 877-300-7645. That's 877-300-7645. Again, flowofwisdom.com is the website. Get connected with me. Leave a message, a note as well. And I'm on Twitter at Sean_Anthony. We'll take a quick commercial break and we'll come back with more right after this on Flow of Wisdom. Welcome back to Flow of Wisdom. Sean Anthony broadcasting live. 877-300-7645. First CRISPR babies that were born last week. Chinese scientist He Jiankui explained his extraordinary claim to have helped produce the first babies, twin girls born with edited genomes, came to a close with a statement that came down hard on the scientists. This is according to Scientific American. "We heard an unexpected and deeply disturbing claim that human embryos had been edited and implanted, resulting in a pregnancy and the first of twins. Even if the modifications are verified, the procedure was irresponsible and failed to conform with international norms." Similar criticism rained down since the revelation earlier this week that He had used the CRISPR-Cas9 to modify the CCR5 gene in two embryos, which he then implanted in a woman. The gene encodes a protein that many strains of HIV used to infect immune cells in two embryos, which he then implanted in a woman. So here's a few of the questions that the article points out. Is He Jiankui in trouble? On November 27th, China's National Health Ministry called on the government, where He's university, the Southern University of Science and Technology, is, to investigate He. 2 days later, the science ministry ordered him to stop doing any science. He had already said the experiments were on hold, and the investigation will proceed is not clear. How the investigation will proceed is not clear. He is accused of transgressing a 2003 Healthy Ministry guideline, which is not a law and has no clear penalties attached to it. Whether He's University, the Southern University of Science and Technology, will take any action against him is also unclear. A university spokesperson told Nature that cannot disclose such information at this moment and to wait for official statements at an appropriate time. He's been on leave since February of 2018 and is scheduled to last until January of 2021. This is crazy, y'all. This is crazy. He has another a site for his lab there still remains several statements praising Jiankui's accomplishments have also disappeared from government sites. See how this is very, very controversial. Even though there's no laws put in place that he has broken, it does cross an ethical line. It's like a blurred ethical line that's being crossed. And it's extremely, extremely controversial. Extremely controversial. The next question they pose is, are the claims accurate? Many scientists have said that an independent body should confirm her scientific claims by performing an in-depth comparison of the parents' and children's genes. The problem is most everyone agrees that the babies and their parents should remain anonymous. Can you imagine, ladies and gentlemen, the type of attention that these children would get publicly if their anonymity was exposed, if they were exposed? I mean, I just could not imagine. I could not imagine, even for the children. Like, they are going to be monitored for the rest of their lives. There's going to be a level of scrutiny and attention on these two twin babies' lives. And it's just, it's going to be like, it's not even like, it's a science experiment. It's a science experiment. This is unprecedented. And this is why it's making rather large headlines than you know, other stories that we would typically cover. Because we're talking about editing DNA. And the first babies, this is the first ones that has been reported. First babies where their DNA and genes have been edited that were actually born. They exist in life. Don't go anywhere. There's more right after this on Flow of Wisdom. Right, welcome back to Flow of Wisdom. I'm your host, Sean Anthony. Let's break a couple of things down. You know, since this news broke out last week, lots of articles that have just been popping up all over the place on the subject matter of CRISPR, gene editing, designer babies, all of those phrases are now in articles all over the place. Let's go to sciencedirect.com and explain briefly what designer babies are. Designer babies are either created from an embryo selected by pre-implantation genetic diagnosis, or they call it PGD, or genetically modified in order to influence the traits of the resulting children. The primary aim of creating designer babies is to avoid their having hereditable diseases coded by mutations in DNA. With the development on this DNA transfer and discover of genome editing tools, the production of precise genome editing designer babies is no longer science fiction. However, knowledge on the risk of these editing tools is insufficient, especially when modifications are heritable. Furthermore, there are ethical concerns as to whether we should apply these techniques to create designer babies. We believe that these germline genetic editing methods should still be considered experimental procedures, and research should continue to improve the method and to assess its long-term safety. So, of course, there's the conversation of pros having pros and cons, but it's extremely controversial because we don't know what the outcome is going to be. Therefore, experiments must take place. But where do we stop? Where is the line going to be drawn? Once you pass a certain limit, then things kind of just you just open up Pandora's box. There was a movie that I seen, man, some years ago. let me see if I can pull it up online. I think it was called Splicing. And this movie freaked me out. It freaked me out. Let me see. It was called Splice. And it came out in 2009. Here it is. Let me pull it up on Wikipedia and read it to you. Splice is a 2009 Canadian-French science fiction horror film. Let's see. The story concerns experiments in genetic engineering being done by a young scientific couple who attempt to introduce human DNA into their work of splicing animal genes. The plot: genetic engineers hope to achieve fame by splicing animal DNA to create hybrids for medical use at the company NERD. Their work previously yielded Fred a dog-sized vermiform creature intended as a mate for their female specimen. Ginger, after successfully mating them, Clive and Elsa plan to create a human-animal hybrid that could revolutionize science. Their employers forbid them from doing this. Instead, they are to find an extract protein used for commercial drug production from Fred and Ginger. Let me just stop right there. This is the reason why I'm bringing this up. I got to tell you the part that freaked me out in this movie. I got to tell you. It's an old movie. Well, it's over 10 years old now. So if I spoil it for you, you'll be all right. You just go back and watch it anyway. But towards the end of the movie, you know, they created this female human slash animal like creature that, you know, they did the gene editing thing, watched it birth, and it grew and older, and it became, I guess, an adult. The male scientist has sex with this creature. Blew my mind. I was like, this is sick. This is disgusting. Whoa, mind blowed, right? I bring this up because this is why this subject of CRISPR gene editing is so controversial, because, like I said, you are opening up Pandora's box now. You're editing human DNA, and then one scientist wants to get curious. Okay, well, what if we put this DNA with another DNA, you know, with the cheetah DNA to send a third? You never know what you're going to create. Let me take a quick moment. Because I don't think I didn't announce this last week, and I found out just last week. But I want to send a rest in peace to Doc Marquis. For those who are not familiar with who Doc Marquis is, Doc Marquis was he claimed to be a former member in the occult and the Illuminati, he was a master witch. And Doc Marquis was a frequent guest on Floor of Wisdom during the early years of Floor of Wisdom Radio. He's been on numerous shows, and you can go back on in my archives on flowofwisdom.com, of course, the YouTube channel Floor of Wisdom, and check out some of my old interviews with Doc Marquis. Really fascinating stuff. And rest in peace. He just passed away last week. For the past several months, he's been battling some health issues. They found a tumor in his brain, according to the Facebook posts that I was tagged in. And he succumbed to those ailments just last week. So rest in peace to Doc Marquis and his family and close friends, and all those that he has, the lives that he has touched. Again, like I said, Doc Marquis has been on the show numerous times. The last time Doc Marquis was on Floor of Wisdom was probably about 2 years ago, maybe 2 or 3 years ago. But the reason why I'm bringing up Doc Marquis, one of the early interviews I had him on, which was probably around the year 2010, 2009, it could have been, maybe 2011, I'm not sure. But one of the things that Doc Marquis told me in one of the early interviews on Floor of Wisdom was that he was like, because he was in the military at one point. He said, Sean, he walked in laboratories where he's seen this whole gene editing thing that we're talking about right now. He said he's seen where they were doing tests, genetic editing, gene editing, where taking, you know, the gene from a cheetah and the gene from, you know, maybe a gorilla, and I'm going off the top of my head, and a gene from a gorilla or something, and mixing the three together to see what comes out of it. He says, Sean, I've walked in laboratories and seen just blobs of just flesh, and it's like it was something indescribable that you've never seen before. Now, you know, this is him telling me his firsthand account of what he witnessed, and I'm bringing this up because it's relevant to what we are discussing today. Lord, no, like this news just came out and it's hit mainstream, right? But Lord knows what they've been working on. We only know what's been documented and what, you know, the papers, the white papers that come out, the research papers that have come out and shared in the scientific arena. This is all that we know. But when Doc Marquis told me that stuff, I don't know, maybe about 8, 9, 10 years ago, it blew my mind away then. Even still reading this stuff, it's baffling. And then when I seen that movie, Splice, and we constantly talk about the propaganda in films, at movies and television shows. You know, it's mirroring reality, if you will. That movie Splice, like, part of me wants to go back and look at it again. Another part of me does not want to see that again. But I'm willing to go back and look at it again for mere, for researching purposes, to kind of really put this all together. But the fact of the matter is that it's real. And if you see it in a film, this is my own opinion, if I see something in a film, then that only lets me know what they've already been working on and experimenting with. But just imagine, you know, being able to witness what Doc Marquis said he witnessed, walking into a laboratory and just seeing blobs of flesh. Like, you couldn't even make out what it was because of the experimenting that they've been working on. Just pure experiments on life. What are your thoughts on this kind of stuff? What do you think the future may be now with this can just open now? What could be the possibilities? What exactly do you think that will be the outcome of this? Could any good become of this? Because, you know, as I say before, and I'll say it again, with the development of new science and technology, for the most part, the intent, at least what they tell us, the intent is to help and improve lives, to find cures to ailments and diseases. And this was what the purpose of this particular scientist of creating these genetically modified human babies, to remove that gene that would, you know, make the child susceptible to HIV and other diseases. But where does it stop? Where does it stop? Hell, last week on the show, I was telling you that scientists predict in the future that humans will be able to have babies with machines. I told you on last week's show that they've already created a robot that has its own menstrual cycle. Like, where does it stop with this experimentation of genes? 877-300-7645. We'll open up the phone lines, take your phone calls, plus I have some more information we're going to share. Don't go anywhere, ladies and gentlemen. This is Flow of Wisdom. right, we're back. Welcome back. Flow of Wisdom. I'm your host, Sean Anthony, 877-300-7645. Get in on the conversation. Let me know your thoughts about what I've talked about so far. And stick around for hour two as I'm going to dive into some more information as it relates to Darwin life. Let's go to Mark in Illinois. Mark wants to talk about genetic experimentation. Mark, welcome to Flow of Wisdom, man. How art thou? Mark, are you there?
I'm looking at the scriptures. If you go back to China, like we're talking about China, China is where the flood of Noah actually happened. And it didn't happen over the whole world. It happened in Asia Minor. And you go back and you look at the Chinese of their history on their temples, they record this ancient flood as destroying their entire country. And so I believe that the evil spirit of the Nephilim, the Raphim, was loose in that country back in the ancient times. And that's why that whole part of the world had to be wiped out, because of the evil technology that they were doing way back then. The other thing is, if you look in Genesis chapter 10, in verse 25, it talks about, it says the brother's name was Joktan. Joktan is the name for Job. And during the time of Job, as you read in here, Peleg, the name of the one was Peleg. That means that you can actually find in the ancient Hebrew, you have to be able to look at the language and understand it, but you can see Atlantis was a civilization that crossed from the Rock of Gibraltar, Africa, the Gates of Hercules, and it was like a group of islands that went across the entire Atlantic, connected to what's the Scottish Islands, and connected to America. And that whole civilization was wiped out. What were they doing that got them wiped out? And then you go to modern times here, 2,000 years ago, that was the modern times, and Peter, the Apostle Peter, writes about in the book of 2 Peter, he says, "But the day of the Lord will come as a thief in the night, when the heavens shall suddenly pass away, and the elements shall separate as they burn, and the earth also, and the works therein that and are in it shall be not found. But since these things are to be dissolved, what manner of persons ought you to be in your holy conduct and godliness?" What I'm saying is that this technology is nothing new, and it's happened before, and civilizations have been wiped out, and it's happening again. And, you know, the Lord's going to bring fire and destruction upon this evil inclination, these evil spirits, and they know their time is close. So they're going to be going as fast as they can to do everything that they can to try to stop the kingdom of God from coming upon the earth. Does that make sense to you?
Mark, it makes absolute perfect sense. You know, and listening to what you were saying, I also want to add to that, you know, out of the book of Enoch. Are you familiar with the book of Enoch, Mark?
Yeah, you know, actually there's 365 books of Enoch.
Right, the book of Enoch, and also in Genesis, you know, where it talks about the Nephilim, and then the archangels in Enoch, it talks about the angels coming down and having sex with humans and creating the Nephilim. Like, it's just, like you said, this is something that has been going on for quite some time, but it's not known. A lot of people don't know about it and don't talk about it as often. Would you agree?
Oh, yeah, I would. It's because, you know, we can't understand the Word of God if we're looking at the English language. We have to have an understanding of the ancient Hebrew and even the Greek as well.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, so do you think that this, what do you think is going to be the end line? Do you think this is going to open up a whole new Pandora's box with these two babies being born?
Oh, I remember seeing a Time Life magazine. I seen an old Time Life magazine from 1961, and they were talking about genetic DNA experiments back then.
Right. Hey, hang on. I got to take a break. I got to go to the second hour. We got to do the news and commercials and all that stuff. Mark, call back if you want to come back in and chime in. I got to take a break. And ladies and gentlemen, if you want to add to the conversation, 877-300-7645. We'll pick up hour two right after this on Flow of Wisdom. Get motivated. Get motivated.
motivated.
Get motivated.